Yo, what's up, everyone? Welcome back again. This is your African boy from South Sudan, myself, Gabs, Gabi, and here we,
KD.
Yeah, this is KD, guys. I do have a lot of reaction with him. And if it is your first time, definitely show us some love so that you don't miss the content out here. So today we are going to react to one Hindu video here by the title Mauritius, Africa only Hindu majority state. So
Mauritius is a country in Africa.
Yeah, it's a country in Africa.
Yeah, like it's in north.
So actually, like, yeah, Hindu is not all over Africa. There is
particular
country like Ghana, Mauritius. Well, I don't know about Mauritius, but it's my first time checking it. I only know about Ghana and you.
I know about Mauritius.
Mauritius, Ethiopia, and Kenya, maybe. So without wasting time, kindly click the like, subscribe now. Let's go.
There are more than 10,000 different religions in existence today. However, only 84% of the population on the planet identify with one of the five major religions, which include Christianity, Buddhism, Islam, Hinduism, or some form of folk religion. Some might argue that the newest religion is no religion at all, although non-believers have been around as long as humans. But believe it or not, periodically new crazy religious movements spring up, such as Copimism, an internet religion, the Church of the Flying Spaghetti Monster, or Pastafarianism, or Tarasim, a trans religion that believes death is optional and that God is technological. Hinduism is the world's third largest religion behind Christianity and Islam, with over 1.2 billion followers, or 16% of the total global population, known as Hindus, wrapped in shiny bright clothes. Idols of Hindu gods and goddesses smile benevolently on thousands of worshippers during Mahashivratri, an ancient annual religious tradition. All this happens at an elevated platform of about 1,800 feet above sea level on a volcanic crater lake. There's nothing extraordinary about this scene, except that this is not India. This is a tiny island nation named Mauritius, found on the east coast of Africa, where apparently the majority of people worship Hindu gods. Let's face it, geography is important in religion. You see, 87% of Christians live in 157 Christian-majority countries, while 75% of Muslims live in Muslim-majority countries. In contrast, a staggering 97% of Hindus live in three Hindu-majority countries, India, Mauritius, and Nepal, with Mauritius being the only country in Africa that is a Hindu-majority state, which means that Hinduism is the most widely professed faith. About 7 million Hindus reside in this picturesque paradise nation of Africa, which amounts to about 50% of the total population. This overwhelming presence of Hindus in a country thousands of kilometers away from India made Prime Minister Narendra Modi describe Mauritius as Little India during his most recent trip to the country, which he said felt more of a homecoming than a foreign trip. In this part of Africa, the Mahashivratri and other Hindu holidays are celebrated just like Ganesh Chaturthi in Mumbai, while Diwali is an official holiday in the country's calendar. The island is also home to a few of the most popular Hindu temples that tourists and locals throng throughout the year. As a result, Mauritius and India have excellent bilateral relations, as India is Mauritius's largest trading partner and has been the largest exporter of goods and services to the country since 2007. The balance of trade is, however, leaning to India's benefit. Nonetheless, Mauritius has also benefited from having a far richer middle power ally in the global arena at its beck and call. For instance, in 2020, Mauritius was placed on the notorious grey list of the Financial Action Task Force, FATF, as well as blacklisted by the European Union for its presumed role as a tax haven for money laundering and terrorist financing. It was India that stood beside Mauritius and helped the country get out of the doomed lists by using its geopolitical clout in the Paris-based watchdog. Remember the volcanic crater lake we talked about at the beginning? Turns out it is one of the most famous places in Mauritius, named Ganga Talao. This lake derives inspiration from the mighty Ganges River in India. The two water bodies are believed to be spiritually connected, and on Hindu festivals, the lake lights up with Hindu rituals. Although Indian origin people constitute nearly 70% of the population, the African nation is a multi-ethnic, multilinguistic, and multi-religious country, with people of Indian descent following mostly Hinduism and Islam. The Franco-Mauritians, Creoles, and people of Chinese descent follow Christianity, though a minority of Sino-Mauritians also follow Buddhism and other Chinese-related religions. Hinduism took root in Africa from the 19th century onwards through the spread of the British Empire, which colonized huge swaths of land throughout Asia and Africa, including almost the entirety of the Indian subcontinent. Many Indians were recruited as contracted servants throughout the British Empire, settling mainly in the British colonies of southern and eastern Africa. The descendants of these settlers often chose to remain in Africa after the end of colonial rule, developing Indo-African communities that remain to this day. The first Indian migrant community was established in Mauritius by Indian emigrants in 1834, the year which slavery was abolished in the British Empire. In the 70 years that followed, an estimated 500,000 contracted laborers, two-thirds of which were Bhojpuri-speaking natives from eastern Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, arrived in Mauritius. It is widely known that Hinduism is a non-process.
Okay. I think that is enough
by 18th,
to understand.
Yeah, by 18th century, Indians were already everywhere in Africa, especially in Mauritius, which is like it's one of the countries where a lot of Indians reside, especially Hinduism. Those one.
Yeah, and you're saying it's the first country like to have the what Hindu what?
Hindu what?
Is it Hindu something like? Monastery?
Okay, first country to have like a monastery. Anyway, it is the first country known that where the Indians first went into.
With the highest population,
yeah,
currently.
The highest population. A lot of Indians are there. Mauritius.
You say how many? Was it like 7, 9?
It was 17, I mean like it was 18, 74.
And how? What was the population of India?
7 million.
7 million.
7 million Indians. Yeah, so
that
now
really
you have such a number. 7 million.
That's a lot.
That's a lot.
Yeah, yeah.
So this is one of the countries in Africa.
Yeah. That if you are
having the highest population of Indians. Mm. So in there there's Madagascar. That island is also Madagascar. Near the near
Mauritius.
Yeah, a very small island, but indeed it is well developed.
Yeah.
Well developed.
So if you want to visit Africa,
yeah,
and you start from Mauritius,
yeah,
and go Ghana, Ethiopia, Kenya, you will definitely find Hindu people a lot there with the Hindu temples. Because in other countries, like you will find the people, but it's rare to find the temple itself. So that was really amazing. Nice thing to know today about Mauritius. I wasn't actually aware that Hindu people are that much in this African country. But yeah, if you love the video, kindly thumbs up and subscribe to our new channel, Love from Africa.